Hi guys, this is Veronica. Today we are going to discuss once again the policies, programs and schemes of the Government of India. This is the part 10 of this video, Government of India. Okay, so this is the part 10 of this video, and today again I have decided to take up two such schemes. For any queries, you can email me on my email address, and for my video updates, you can follow me on Instagram, or for the PDF of this lecture, you can follow me on Facebook. So guys, this is a channel Study IQ. If you're preparing for any government exam, you can call on these numbers, as our pen drive courses are also available, and for the additional information, you can call on these numbers or you can log into our website. So today's scheme that we are going to cover are Wi-Fi Chopal Unnat Bharat Abhiyan. So let's take up this question. What is the aim of the program Unnat Bharat Abhiyan? Achieving 100% literacy by promoting collaboration between voluntary organization and government's education system in local communities. Second option is connecting institutions of higher education with local communities to address development challenges through appropriate technologies. Third option is strengthening India's scientific research institutions in order to make India a scientific and technological power. And the last option is developing human capital by allocating special funds for healthcare and education of rural and urban poor, and organizing skill development program and vocational training for them. So you can give your right answer in the comment section. So let's start the Wi-Fi Chopal. This is basically an initiative of CSC. Now, what is CSC? CSC are basically Common Service Centers. Okay, let me write here. It is Common Service Centers. These are basically the physical facilities for delivering Government of India e-services. Okay, Government of India's e-services to rural and remote locations. Okay, rural and remote locations where the availability of computers and internet is negligible, or you can say mostly absent. They are multiple service single point model for providing facilities for multiple transactions at a single geographical location. So there are like few more things about CSC. Like these are the access points for delivery of essential public utility services, even the social welfare schemes and the healthcare schemes, financial, educational and agriculture services. Apart from other services, it is also pan-India network catering to regional, geographic, linguistic and cultural diversity of the country. So what government is trying to do through CSC, that government is enabling the government's mandate of socially, financially and digital inclusive society. Okay, so this was just about CSC, as it is an initiative of CSC. So it was important for you to know what is CSC. It is actually already a project. Okay, this is already a project under Digital India program. Now let's talk about Wi-Fi Chopal. Now under Wi-Fi Chopal, it is a government initiative that provides Wi-Fi hotspots in rural areas where people can access the internet by subscribing to low data plans. Okay, in rural panchayat. So Wi-Fi Chopal is aiming to connect around 2.5 lakh gram panchayats in the country through highly scalable network infrastructure that is known as optical fiber cable. Now what is optical fiber cable? This is basically a thin flexible fiber with a glass core, okay, with a glass core through which the light signals can be sent with very little loss of strength. Okay, so if there is one data center here and the other data center here, how we will transmit the data between the two centers? So it is done through optical fiber cable. We use this cable as the loss of strength, the loss of data does not take place due to the process of total internal reflection because of the presence of glass core. Okay, so this is about Wi-Fi Chopal. Now at present, around 7000 GPS for gram panchayats of the country are in place with Wi-Fi, and now under Wi-Fi Chopal, they are trying to expand the reach of internet to the rural and remote areas. Okay, so the telecom department also recently floated a tender to install 5 lakh Wi-Fi hotspots across Gram Panchayats, the estimated cost of which has been pegged at 4,000 crore. Now, what are the objectives of this project? Now, according to the Department of Telecommunication, the project strives to give rural areas access to the internet and keep them updated on the developments around the country. Right, the Wi-Fi hotspots will also allow people in rural areas to connect to social institutions like police, that we will again talk in our further slides. Now, Wi-Fi Chopal is also entrusted with the development of affordable and reliable communication infrastructure in rural areas and leverages the endpoints on National Optic Fiber Network of BharatNet. Now, what is BharatNet? That Wi-Fi Chopals will be installed with the help of BharatNet. Now, BharatNet is Centers Rural Connectivity Program. So, what is BharatNet? It is Centers Rural Connectivity Program. Ignore my handwriting. So it is Centers Rural Connectivity Program, which is implemented by BBNL. BBNL stands for Bharat Broadband Network Limited, and they use this optical fiber. So to realize the vision of Digital India, that is the main of aim of the Bharat Net, and it is funded by Universal Service Obligation Fund. So this was BharatNet, and this Wi-Fi Chopal scheme, BharatNet will help to expand this scheme. Okay, now the tariff plans range are also very cheap, like from rupees 10 to rupees 950 for period of 10 days to 28 days. The minimum Wi-Fi plan costs rupees 10, under which the user can even avail the 500 MB internet data. Now, the which kind of services will be available under Wi-Fi Chopal? Under the scheme, the official websites, people will be offered Wi-Fi hotspots in their villages, internet services at home, the internet services of purpose for carrying out official work or business activities, and even the Wi-Fi service provided through these hotspots will also allow user to make voice calls using the broadband. Now, about the installation of such programs, where the population is around up to 1,000, you can say, one Wi-Fi hotspot will be installed, and if the population is 1,000 to 3,500, then two Wi-Fi hotspots will be installed. If the population is from 3,500 to 7,500, three Wi-Fi hotspots will be launched, and then if it's above 12,000, five Wi-Fi hotspots will be installed. And where the BharatNet infrastructure is not available, then the government has even signed a parallel agreement with the service providers like Airtel and Vodafone to utilize their infrastructure to provide connectivity in the Gram Panchayats. So in addition to the Wi-Fi based services, CSC, the Community Service Center, is also providing some additional services like internet at home, I told you, internet for offices, optical fiber maintenance also. So this is about Wi-Fi Chopal services. And yeah, one more thing, that with the Wi-Fi Chopals, one more advantage is there for the, you know, the village people, the general villagers, that they will be connected to the last mile government agencies as customers. Okay, they will get the strong connectivity also to the 5 P's. What are the 5 P's? Like the post office. These are the main essentials in an area, in a village, in a rural setup. Post office, police station, primary health center, panchayat office, primary school. So you can also add, you know, such a point gives you extra marks when you write the 5 P's of the village. Okay, let's move to the next scheme, that is Unnat Bharat Abhiyan. It is launched by Ministry of Human Resource Development. It is the second edition of Unnat Bharat Abhiyan. Now, what is the vision of this? What is the purpose of Unnat Bharat Abhiyan? The vision to transform India. What is the vision? That it is inspired by the vision of transformational change in rural development processes by leveraging knowledge institutions to help build the architecture of an inclusive India. And how it can be done? Basically, there's an intention to enrich the rural India. Here we are talking for a vision, we need to set up a mission. And the mission of Unnat Bharat Abhiyan is to enable higher educational institutions to work with the rural people, okay, to work with the rural people, rural India, in identifying development challenges and evolving appropriate solutions for accelerating sustainable growth. Okay, and another aim of this program is to create a virtuous cycle between society and academic system. Between society and academic system by providing knowledge and practices for emerging professions and to upgrade the capabilities of both the public and private sectors in responding to the development needs of the rural India. So this is the mission, like the higher educational institute with the latter providing the knowledge and technology support to improve the livelihoods of the rural areas, to upgrade the capabilities of both public and private organizations in the society. Now there was a first edition of Unnat Bharat Abhiyan also where lesser number of higher educational institutes were involved, but now it has extended up to 750 reputed higher educational institutes, both public and private of the country, are a part of this scheme. IIT Delhi has been designated as its national coordinating institute for this program. So what is the structure of this program? Let me draw here. Like at the apex, it is the Ministry of Human Resource and Development. Then there is a National Steering Committee. Then the institutes, this IIT Delhi, that is the National Coordinating Institute. Let me write here, IIT Delhi, that is a National Coordinating Institute. Then there are government agencies also involved, state nodal officers. Okay, I don't know what's happening to the pen. IIT Delhi. Then there are monitoring institutions. Then there are subject expert groups. Then there are many other participatory institutions which will adopt many clusters of villages. Okay, clusters of villages or panchayats, and in between district administration will be involved, panchayati raj institutions will be involved, and many voluntary organizations will be involved. Like if the students have finally identified the problems and have suggested various ways, then the implementation can only take place when the district administration is involved, panchayati raj institutions are involved, and voluntary organization. All three, they all are working together to implement those solutions, right? So now this is an HRD ministry's initiative. Okay, now Unnat Bharat Abhiyan basically is a flagship program also, and it is significant initiative where all higher learning institute have been involved for participation in development activities. Now I have shown you the structure also, how it's going to work. So basically the only objective of the scheme is to engage the faculty and students. This is the objective of the program, to engage the faculty and students of higher education institutions in understanding the rural realities, the living conditions of the adopted villages, that are the rural realities. Later they should identify and select the existing innovative technologies and enable customization of technologies or devise implementation methods for innovative solutions as required by the people of the villages, those they have adopted. right? So to allow higher educational institution to contribute to devise systems for smooth implementation of various government programs, such knowledge inputs would make their way into the development programs in rural India. This is one of the very good schemes I have seen over the period of time. Now, I hope you will be able to answer the question. The correct answer is connecting institutions of higher education with local communities to address development challenges through appropriate technologies. This is about today's lecture. Thank you. For any queries or my video updates, you can contact me on social network. And even I have a group on Telegram. You can contact me there also. Thank you.